Vostok by Bill Murphy.
This is Bob Gunning, reporting live from the Russian Antarctic Research Station, Vostok, one of the most isolated, coldest and windiest places on Earth. However, 4 kilometres under the ice beneath us is one of the world's largest freshwater lakes. An expedition is to be launched tomorrow, where a submersible with a crew of 3 will travel through the ice cap in an ice drilling machine and then descend into the frigid waters of the subglacial lake. This represents years of preparation by the man behind the mission, billionaire adventurer Nils Skallagrimson, who joins me now. Mr. Skallagrimson.
Nils on TV again?
Yeah, all the networks.
It's turning into a media circus.
Yes, Nils for you. Can't resist a camera.
Well, I just hope he remembers this is a scientific expedition, not some publicity stunt.
I'm not sure Nils knows the difference sometimes. Here's coffee.
Thank you. Are we still sticking with the launch time?
Yep, tomorrow, 0600 hours. As far as I'm concerned, we should just go down, get our samples, and get the heck out of there.
It's not as straightforward as that.
Well, maybe it should be.
Lake Vostok is one of the most isolated places on the planet, with a unique and fragile ecosystem. We have to be careful not to contaminate the lake, and make sure we leave it as unspoiled as we found it.
Yeah. Lancius has been treated with supercritical fluids. Contamination should be minimal.
I still laugh when I hear that name. Huh? Lancius. How did he come up with that?
How many times have I got to tell you? Lancius was
one of the Argonauts. Yeah. I know. He could see all the way to the center of the Earth. I remember.
Yeah. I'm not worried about the name of the sub. I just want to make sure she withstands the pressure.
Can Lancius handle it?
I hope so.
You hope?
Look, Anna, this is Neil's baby. Right from the start, I didn't have that much input into the design of the sub or its systems. No matter how good the Lancius is, there's always a risk.
I know, but I've studied marine life in some of the remotest areas in the world, from the Galapagos to the Arctic Ocean, but Vostok, there is nothing like it in the world. And we'll be the first humans ever to enter its waters.
Exactly, that's why we're all prepared to take the risk. I don't want to miss it.
Well, we did find traces of bacteria in the ice core just above the lake. So maybe we might just find something similar down there.
Are we going to find anything larger than bacteria?
No, I don't think so. Yeah. Can't really see how they could survive in such extreme conditions.
Well, yeah, I've seen those tube worms. Some up to a few meters long around thermal vents in the Pacific.
Riftia pachyptula.
Yeah, I knew that.
Extremely unlikely in Vostok, I would say.
Oh, Nils thinks of... or hopes that volcanic activity on the lake could produce enough heat in the water to sustain all sorts of life.
Anything is possible, but like I said, very unlikely. If anything, it might provide an interesting energy source for microorganisms of a novel metabolic phylogenetic type.
Phylo what?
Phylogenetic. Well, basically a different form of life than we would find anywhere else.
Oh, that's why you're going down? Just to see if there's some tiny microbe, which you can't see without a microscope, that can't be found anywhere else.
Oh, microbiologists are easily pleased. Why do you want to go down?
You see, I grew up in Oklahoma. The ocean was more than 1,000 miles away. My granddaddy said that if you drained the sea of all its water, it looked like the landscape around us. Now, from that point on, I was hooked.
The bigger question, I suppose, is why Nils is doing it.
Yeah. I guess it's his dream. He can afford it.
Base, this is Lancius.
Please confirm we are at injection point.
What depth are they, Colonel?
Telemetry shows 4105.6 meters below us.
Begin injection startup sequence.
Sequence running. 50 seconds and counting.
We confirm, Dave. The Lancius is ready to punch through the ice cap.
Injection startup sequence running. 40 seconds to injection on my mark. Mark, please confirm.
Confirm.
Well, Nils, your dream is about to come true.
Thank you, Dave. It's taken many years to get to this point. Exploring Lake Vostok has been one of my aims that, as you say, is about to be realized. Anna, as a microbiologist, you also have much to discover here.
My instruments are already recording data from subsurface probes. The trajectory of the Linceus is as we discussed?
Of course.
We'll be traveling down the northern basin wall, Anna.
Dave, I'm feeding some new coordinates into the navigation computer.
As we go down, I'd like to get some samples of the ice wall. Could hold some interesting organisms.
As agreed, Anna.
Linceus, please stand by. Injection in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Mark.
Everything all right, Dave?
Yeah, that's just Linceus letting us know who's boss. The hydraulic arm is pushing us through the final layer of ice, all within the tolerance of the sub.
What's happened?
Anna? Niels? Welcome to Lake Vostok.
Undocking in 3, 2, 1, mark.
Base, we are in and stabilized.
Roger, we confirm. Checking all feeds now.
Let's get the sonar on.
Yeah, hold on, Niels.
Power, comms, telemetry, and biometric monitor feeds all okay. You're go to power up the sub.
Hitting primary power switch. Base running onboard systems check.
Okay.
Primary controls check. Thrusters powered. Anna, instrumentation?
All online. Depth showing 4,351 meters below surface of ice sheet. Cabin pressurization steady.
How are the sensors, Niels?
Up and running. Plotting the contours of the lake. Scanning sonar online.
Okay. You can power the external lights and cameras.
Okay.
Look at it. The most isolated environment on the planet.
Hmm. How about that?
Base, can you see what we're seeing on the video feed?
Roger, all video feed's been recorded. Looks great, guys. All systems normal?
I can't believe it, we're in. By the look of things, neither can they. All systolic heart rates elevated.
It's hardly surprising, my own heart's pounding. Cabin pressure okay?
Yeah, all stable. Oxygen mix at normal.
Okay, Dave, ready to take her down. Everything looks good from here.
Roger. Adjusting hydroplane trim and engaging the thrusters. Hold on your seats, people. Here we go. Dive, dive, dive. Gyro showing angle of 47 degrees.
Rate of descent, 4 meters per second.
Sonar shows ice wall dead ahead. Yes, there it is. Amazing. 40 million years old.
Could hold organisms from when the ice cap froze over the lake. Dave, can we stop to deploy the collector arm to take a water and ice sample?
Not yet. I want to get down to about 200 meters.
But we must get a sample as soon as we can, in case we have to turn back.
I'm well aware of that, Anna.
No, it's...
I haven't spent 15 million pounds of my own money just to go sightseeing. Take her down to 200 meters, Dave.
All right, you're the boss.
200 meters, then we can stabilize.
Pitching down.
.4 meters. 198.5 meters.
Base?
GPS shows you should be at their location.
What are you talking about?
Okay, we can start leveling out now, Dave. We'd collect the first sample here.
Leveling out, cutting back thruster power. Whoa. Hold on.
You guys okay down there?
What was that?
Not sure. We're okay. We're okay. We're stabilizing.
What happened down there? The gyro reading jumped a bit.
Felt like turbulence.
Are you kidding? All the way down here?
I don't understand it, Pete. What would cause water movement like that?
Stabilizing. We're okay, Base. Check the tether line.
Linceus, tether line secure. No problems as far as we can see.
Okay. Sample collection procedure initiated.
Collection complete. 10 liters of pure lake water.
Confirmed depth?
203.6 meters.
Good.
Drifting sideways slightly. Compensating with thrusters. Yeah, I'd be a lot happier if we were in open water.
Just keep her steady.
Turning on organic probe and fluorescent fiber optics. The streams coming through. Yes, we are getting traces. Organic compounds present. Congratulations, everyone. We may not be the only carbon-based creatures down here.
Okay, good. Let's go deeper and take a sample of ice from the ice wall.
Pitching down. The jagged outcrops of ice as we go deeper. A lot of ledges.
Just keep going, Dave. Slowly and carefully.
Lincius, you have a target 40 meters below you and closing on your position at 5 meters per second.
I see it on the sonar.
It's 30 meters directly under you, Dave.
Thrusters at full power.
Camera's not picking anything up.
Got to get out of the way.
I can see something. Directly under us. It's huge. Coming right up at us.
10 meters in closing.
It's going to hit us.
Come on.
It's like a huge block of ice.
Turn, damn you.
5 meters. Here it comes.
It's no good. The controls, they won't respond.
Lincius, this is Base. Can you read me? Dave. Niels. Lincius, come in.
The power's cut. They've no way of...
Base. This is Lincius.
Are you all right?
It was just like a huge block of ice.
We're okay. Stand by, Base.
Of course. A clathrate.
A what?
Pockets of gas trapped in the ice. They occur in cold, deep, high-pressure waters. Very unstable when disturbed. And very dangerous.
I'm calling this mission off. It's too risky.
Now, hold on.
If that clathrate hit us directly, we would be dead. Do you understand? Now, we're going back up.
Look at that.
What is it, Anna?
We're here.
What?
There is a gap in the ice. Look.
Base, I think we found the fissure.
GPS confirms.
We think the fissure leads to another lake.
Another lake?
Satellite studies we ran last year suggested the possibility, but we couldn't be sure.
We? You mean you and the boys on the surface?
Look, we felt it wasn't crucial to the expedition.
What?
If we came across a fissure along the ice wall, then it might be worth exploring.
Oh, this is unbelievable.
Come on, we're wasting time. Take us through.
What other information haven't you shared with us?
Dave, take Lynch's through. Now.
Okay. Base, we're going through.
Roger that, Lincius. Good luck.
According to the readout, it's a tight squeeze. But you should be able to get through.
Anna, keep an eye on the port side. This is crazy, Niels.
Just keep going.
We have about a foot to spare on this side.
If we break off one of the thrusters on the ice, we could be stuck here forever.
You're doing just fine.
Damn you, Niels.
We're okay.
That was close.
Yeah, too close. Can't risk another one of those.
There should be a 60-degree turn to port.
Yeah, I see it. Stabilizing.
We're through.
Wait, is it part of Vostok or is it another lake?
Base, this is Lincius. We're out.
Good job, Dave.
Yeah, right.
Sonar on.
Are you looking for something?
Niels? Is there something down there?
You're picking this up, Base?
Yeah, solid object. Static. 38 meters below you.
Take us down. 40 meters.
Are we sure about this? It could be just a rocky outcrop.
Come on. Let's go.
Now, I don't like this.
Where's your sense of adventure, Dave? We have to go and check it out. Take us down.
Niels, we're nearing the limits of what Lincius can do.
What are we looking for?
Keep going. There!
It looks metallic.
That's it.
It's another submersible.
Well, how can that be?
Base, are you seeing this?
Yeah, we see it. You've got it. You found it.
Found what, Niels?
The Rostov.
You knew about this all along.
Why didn't you tell us about this?
She's quite beautiful. The freezing water has preserved it well. What are you doing, Dave? We need to get closer.
I'm turning around.
You can't!
Yes, I can, and I will. Unless you tell us what's going on. Well?
The last transmission from the Russian Navy sub, Rostov, was on October 23rd, 1987. It was a scientific expedition to find traces of life in Lake Vostok.
And what happened?
Nobody knows for sure. But it collided with something and was never seen again. Until now. The Soviets kept it quiet from the world. The three crewmen were lost. But I had heard a rumor about it. And when the old USSR fell apart, well, let's just say some more information came available for price.
You've been planning this for years. To recover the sub?
Why? Why all this money and effort?
Let's just go closer to the Rostov, and then maybe I can answer all your questions.
Okay. This is as close as I dare get. She's teetering on that ice ledge. I can't risk her falling off into the depths. Look, we'll never get to her.
It was one of the most advanced submersibles of its time.
Those gushes in the side of it. Did she just collide with the ice wall or...
Yeah, maybe. But look at the impact marks. They don't look like the ones you'd get by crashing against the ice. It's weird.
I can't see the crew. Not from this distance.
Can we get a little closer?
No. It's too dangerous. The Rostov is too unstable. The ice ledge could collapse at any time. I'm not risking the Lincius.
This isn't your sub.
I know it's not, but you hired me to pilot it.
And you are being paid handsomely for it.
It's not worth putting our lives at risk.
What about a few degrees to port, Dave? We could then see inside the sub with the robot camera.
We have to find out what happened.
And then we're out of here.
And then we go.
I don't believe I'm doing this. Anna, you keep a lookout on the port side. Nils, you take the starboard. Now make sure the light gantries don't get caught up in the wreckage. There's a lot of loose cabling.
That's it. Just a little closer.
I can almost see inside.
What could have caused such damage? Every part of it is mangled.
She's shifting. The thrusters are causing too much water turbulence.
You're there. We can see inside.
There are no bodies. Nothing but twisted metal. What happened to the crew? There is nothing left of them.
The ledge is collapsing. Reversing thrusters, full power.
Watch the cables.
Yeah, I see them.
Going down, the cable on the camera.
We're not going down without a fight. Auxiliary powered thrusters.
The arm has broken off. The Rostov is falling away.
Lincius, are you clear?
Roger, base. We're clear.
She's falling. She's gone. I can't see it anymore.
I told you we were...
I can't believe it. There is something fast approaching from beneath. 90 meters. 70 meters.
What?
I can't see it.
It's heading straight for us. Its signature is different. It can't be a clathrate. They can't move that quick.
Full power.
20 meters. 10 meters.
Move it.
I'm trying.
Come on.
They've been hit. All data streams, telemetry, and comms are down. The tether may have been severed in the impact.
Lincius, can you read me?
I'm getting a signal from the transponder, complete with data block.
Has he got their position?
Yes. They're still descending, spiraling down according to the transponder.
Starboard hydroplanes and thrusters are out. We only got power in the port propellers. Base, can you hear us? This is Lincius.
He was alive. He was swimming.
What do you mean, swimming?
I think I saw a tail. A long tail.
The sub is out of control. I can't level out. We're going down. Hang on. Wait a minute. There's a ledge.
I'm gonna try steering towards it.
They've stopped on an ice ledge or some sort of outcrop, according to the sonar. The transponder indicates no vertical movement.
What depth?
581 meters below the lake ceiling. If they can't control the sub, how are they going to get back up?
Come in, Base. This is Lincius. Base, do you read? Oh, communications are out.
Sonar and echo sounder are out. I can't tell where we are.
Secondary instruments, cameras and external lights are also down. What happened to us?
It hit us.
What hit us? I didn't see anything.
I just can't believe it. They were right.
Who were right?
We got hold of the transmission tapes for the Rostov. The last words that one of the crew members was shouting just before they stopped was, "Seamaster."
You mean the Rostov was attacked by some sort of creature?
Creature? Look, wait a minute, I've heard enough of this. We have to figure out a way of getting out of here. This ice ledge won't support us for too much longer.
How? We have no power. Our umbilical has been cut in the impact.
I know. Without the tether, they can't winch us back up to Tippus. We'll have to conserve every bit of power in the batteries for the remaining thruster, and use the emergency transponder to find our way back up. Our oxygen is going to be running out, and the batteries can't run the scrubbers and power the thruster. I figure we got about 3 hours.
Okay, Dave. Try to get us out of here.
Pete, the sonar shows Lincius is moving. She's moving off the ice ledge. Let's hope she has enough power to get her back up. Come on. Come on, Dave. Bring her up. They still have to get through the fissure and into the main body of the lake and up the Tiffus before their O2 runs out.
Thruster at full power.
We're going up.
No, not fast enough. It's too much for just one thruster. We'll have to pump out the collection tanks.
It's coming back. Picking up another target below them.
Moving like the last one?
Yes. But what? His course is erratic. Zigzagging. He's getting closer to them.
How far are they from the opening?
40 meters. They're not going to make it. You're not going to believe this. Whatever it is, it's circling the sub.
We must have shorted something. We're really draining power on the batteries, the ones we have left.
I can see the fissure dead ahead, about 20 meters.
What the?
It's coming after us.
There. Something's moving in the boat. It's moved ahead of us.
What the hell is that thing?
Must be at least 150 feet long. We have to get this on camera.
What? They're all dead. What's it doing? It's just floating there as if it's waiting for us. Oh, my. This is what happened to the Rostov. I'm getting us out of here right now.
It's moving.
We have to get back through the fissure.
I've never seen anything like it.
Now we're too slow. We have to flush the tanks. Nils, open the tanks.
It's too late.
I'll do it. Damn it!
There is a fissure just ahead.
It's almost on top of us. Hang on!
What's happened? Have they made it through? The sub and the target have merged just at the mouth of the fissure.
Did it hit them?
No. No, Lincius is continuing through. The other target is moving back. Descending back into the other lake.
Will we make it?
CO2 levels are high, but we should be okay.
Thank you, Dave.
Save it.
You know, nobody will believe us.
Hey, we're still in one piece, aren't we?
We need to go back down, and soon.
What do you mean?
We came back with nothing. Only what we saw with our own eyes. We have no proof of the existence of that sea creature. We have to go down again.
Are you nuts? Look what happened to the Russian sub. What almost happened to us.
Maybe there is more than just one. A whole colony of undiscovered species.
Prehistoric relics, isolated in the lake when the Antarctic ice cap formed. It's remarkable discovery. The greatest in centuries.
Oh, you're starting to sound like him. I blame the CO2. Right now, I just want to get us out of here.
We have to tell the Russians we found their sub.
They will deny it ever existed. We have to keep quiet about everything until we go down again and get it on camera.
Well, here's the docking arm on Tippus.
Think about it. We could be part of one of the greatest scientific discoveries ever.
We would be the first people in the world to study a live prehistoric creature.
What about you, Dave?
Well, we're gonna need a bigger sub.
In Vostok by Bill Murphy. Dave was played by Stuart Milligan, Niels by Ingvar Sigurdsson, and Anna by Brana Bajic. Pete was played by David Earl, and Callum by Nick Dannon. Vostok was directed by Lawrence Jackson.